this video, we are going to talk a little bit more about as far as organizing a DaVinci Resolve project, but also actually starting to pull in some content to work with in the project. Now, before I begin, one thing I'd like to do is actually here on the main page before I dive into my first video project is I want to make sure I have an export of it. This is a good use if you have multiple people working on a project, but also to just so that you have a backup in case you move from one computer to another. So I'm going to make sure that this My First Video is highlighted. You can tell by, you know, the red around it. And down in the lower left-hand corner, I'm going to click a quick export. And it's going to go, in my case, I had found my DaVinci project, and you can see the export file is a .drp, DaVinci Resolve Project. So I'm going to go ahead here now. And I'm going to click Save. And let's go ahead and double click and open this up here. Okay, so now I'm working in DaVinci Resolve as far as my first project goes. But I do want to draw your attention here. And I'm going to go ahead and actually jump up to Pixabay. But also, I'd like to come back to that folder on the desktop just so you can see what happened there. Notice now I have a little DaVinci Resolve project here stored in my folder. Also in this folder, I'd like to move a lot of my content that I will be working with. So on Pixabay, you have a lot of great videos. You can actually navigate to the video section. A lot of 4K here. I actually kind of had an idea already that I wanted to kind of use like trees, forest, and snow. I thought that'd be pretty. So I'll go ahead and download. I'll keep it at 1920 by 1080. Okay, so there we go. It's going to start downloading. I'm going to actually X out of this while that is downloading. And then I also wanted to go. Actually, this would be a good choice here. This is a nice choice. 1920 by 1080. Great. Along with video, just to remind folks, it doesn't have to always be video. You can actually use photographs as well. So maybe I come in here and let's type in winter and see what I come up with. So I had two folks walking through the forest. I had you know, maybe kind of a nice one here. Here we go, 1920 by 1280. Okay, so we got a couple of options here. Now, one of the next things that I want to do, though, is I'm going to jump into downloads. And I'm going to do a Control X because I want to just copy and paste these directly into this folder with my project. Again, I'm keeping everything all together here. So now a couple of things that I can do here as far as media is concerned, and I'm going to click on that media button, is I now can add clips into my media pool where I'm right-clicking and importing media. Or if you want to do it faster, we could do Control I. So it's going to navigate out to your Explorer. And I'm going to go ahead and use the Control key and just open all three of these so I have them. So here now you can see I can kind of preview what I'm going to be working with as far as the media is concerned for each of these. Awesome. So I now have the media in place here that I can actually, you have two options actually. You can come into the cut and begin to actually set up as far as just dragging and dropping. So for instance here, I'll go ahead and place this right at the start. And I'll go ahead here now. And you can see here I have kind of this starting playback head. That's letting me know where it's going to begin as far as playing back. I can also come up into the timeline preview window And I can hit play, and you can see how it, it's playing exactly what I had there. So let's say, though, I want to do some additional edits as far as the overall layout is concerned. So let's start with a basic edit here. If I jump into edit here, this is probably one of the bigger areas you might find yourself working in. So first off, to break down for folks, just to get started, notice up here, here's that media we imported, but also notice there's this timeline one now listed. That's what we're seeing down here. So maybe what I decide to do is, you've got the video playthrough here as far as going through and working with the video. I have a couple of options. We'll start out with the basics. So I decide I want this video to start playing right after the other one here. So we kind of play through. And there we go. Now that's just the basics of placing elements. I want to show one more item as far as placing, because remember, we've kind of got this random soap bubble going on. I just wanted to be able to show you how you work with an image in a video project. Also, too, it's not like you're locked into, like you see video one and audio one. I'm not locked into working in a single layer here. Like maybe for sake of argument, I want this soap bubble to kind of be the middle portion here for whatever reason. It's going to be a crossover. So now when I play through or I scrub through using the playback head here, you see how it'll actually open the soap bubble and then go back in, and you can actually see the sides there as well. So super important soap bubble, and then we go right back to the people walking. So that's just some of the basics of working on a timeline. So that's something that I encourage folks get comfortable with. Just working between multiple layers, seeing how things work with one another, and going in and making basic tweaks as far as, okay, just getting those elements in position first. After that, then we can start to get more in depth as far as editing and transitions to make it a little bit more interesting and engaging to watch. Lastly, though, friendly reminder, you want to make sure that you do file and you save that project. And then it'll save to the project file, and then you can come back and work on it at a later point in time.